Hey guys, in this lesson you will learn how to create terrain from contours in 3ds Max. This is a topography data file that I want to clean up from all unnecessary information like text objects, symbols, and axis layer before I'll import it into 3ds Max. To do so, select the Isolate Layer tool and click only on the Contours layer. This will hide all the others. Now select all lines and copy them with Ctrl-C on the keyboard. Then open a new file and paste it by clicking Ctrl-V close to the grid's origin. Click Zoom Extend to see all the objects. It's important to have height information in this contour file and not a flat plan for this to work in 3D. I always like to make sure that the file is clean by using two simple commands. The first one is Purge, which deletes all empty items. Just select all and type Purge in the command line. Click on Purge All. The second command is Overkill, which deletes all overlapping lines. You can see that four overlapping objects were deleted. Lastly, we need to move all objects into one layer, so they will become one object in 3ds Max. Give the layer a unique name so it will be easy to be found when importing. Save the file. In 3ds Max, click on Import and select the AutoCAD file. Select the right units for your plan and under the Layer tab, check only the Contours layer. Now we have a nice and clean spline object to work with in 3D. To convert the spline object into mesh, select it and under the compound object, click on Terrain. Not too bad. But if you look closer, you'll see that the mesh is really messy and hard to work with. There is a very nice free plugin called Terrain by Popular3D that we can use to fix up our mesh. Let's convert the object into editable poly. To install the plugin, go to popular3d.com and download it first. After installation, you'll find it under Tools, Populate Terrain. Click on Preview Grid to view the new typology guidelines. Go to Top View to see it better. You can change the grid by number of subdivs, size of polygons, or percentage. To get perfect squares, click on Approximate Squares. I'll set the polygon size to 20 meters. Hit the process button when you're done. Now we have a nice and square polygons. Convert it to editable poly once more and add a turbo smooth modifier for more details. Thanks very much for watching, and please don't forget to subscribe to my channel for my upcoming videos.